हेलो वन एंड ऑल, आई मिसेस अर्चना सेठ, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर कंप्यूटर इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट AISSMS IOIT. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट कंस्ट्रक्टर्स एंड डिस्ट्रक्टर्स इन C++. इन द लास्ट वीडियो लेक्चर वी हैव सीन हाउ द इनकैप्सुलेशन प्रॉपर्टी इज सैटिस्फाइड बाय द कंसेप्ट ऑफ क्लास. सो द कंस्ट्रक्टर इज अ स्पेशल टाइप ऑफ मेंबर फंक्शन which belongs to a class and which is invoked automatically whenever a object of that particular class is created. The name to this special kind of member function is given as a constructor because it is used to construct the initial values of the member variables of that particular class in memory. The constructors are explicitly written as a part of a class. Or if the user has not written the constructors, it can be implicitly inserted whenever the program is compiled. So as you can see in the slide, there is a class number, the member variable NO, and the normal member function display data. Whenever this particular program is given for the compilation, the compiler is going to insert its own constructor which is having the same name as that of the class. So this is implicit insertion of a constructor in a particular class if user has not written his own constructor. So this is the view whenever the explicit constructor is not written in a particular class. The constructor can be inserted, can be written explicitly. So how the constructors are written? The constructors are of three different types: a default constructor, meaning the constructor which does not carry any parameters; the parameterized constructors, which is used to initialize a particular data member of a class through constructor; and a copy constructor. If you want to initialize any particular object with the existing object, then the copy constructor is used. So we'll see one by one. So as you can see, there is a class number with two member functions and one member variable. In main, whenever you create an object and without taking the data, if you just give a call to display data, it is going to display some value. So this value is nothing but the garbage value which is assigned to this member variable NO by the default constructor which has been implicitly called and which is implicitly inserted by compiler, which is a default constructor. Now let's see this example. In this, there is a member variable and the explicit constructor declaration and definition in the class itself. So this is the constructor name, and NO is a member variable which has been initialized to zero. So whenever the object of this variable is of this class is created, the constructor gets called automatically, and the output, as you can see, because of this function call n1.displayData is zero. Meaning what? Whenever the program is given for the execution, the compiler is going to call this constructors on its own. No explicit call is required, meaning I cannot say n1.number and opening closing bracket. So whenever the execution comes to this particular line, the constructor gets called. NO is initialized to the value which has been assigned as here, and whenever the display data function is called, the value which has been assigned because of this constructor will get displayed. So this is the use of constructor, which is used to initialize the member variables. The member variables can be a public, private, or protected. So the next point is next type is parameterized constructor. The parameterized constructor prototype is the class name followed by parenthesis, and in parenthesis we need to give the parameter which you want to initialize. So suppose n2 is the object name, and value, the constant value which we have passed as 100. So this 100, whenever this object is about to create, it will the this value will be passed to this variable no. no1, this no1 will be assigned to a member variable no, and because of these n1.display and n2.display, these two values are printed as an output. So n1 will give a call to the default constructor, which is explicitly written as a part of class, and n2 is the parameterized constructor which is going to carry value as 100. So this 100 will be a value to member variable no. Next is a copy constructor. So the prototype of copy constructor is the constructor name, and the parenthesis, in parenthesis the parameter is the ampersand n. N is nothing but the object. So as this is the object, the data type is number. At the time of call, the call will be given as n3 in bracket n2, where this n2 is the object which has been already created. So here I can give either n2 or n1. So whenever this object is about to create, it will give a call to this constructor, and this constructor values in this particular function call, constructor call, the value, the right hand side will be assigned to left hand side, that is no. And as we have passed n2 as a parameter, and n2's no is 100 because of this parameterized constructor call. So the output, in output we can see, because of n1 the value is 0, because of n2 the value is 100, and n3 is the duplicate copy of n2, that's why the next output is also 100. So this is about the constructor. The in memory, the number class, the n1 object with its own member variable copy, the local copy with value 0, n2 with its own local copy in no, and its value is 100. And as we have created in this example, the with n2, that's why this no is also having a value as 100. So this can be the memory layout of a class and its respective objects, which has been created by different parameters. So here if I say n1 n2 into 100, n3 into n in bracket n2, n1 will give a call to a default constructor, n2 will give a call to a parameterized constructor, and n3 will give a call to a copy constructor. So in case of n2 and n3, both carries the parameter, but the basic difference is, in case of parameterized constructor, the explicit constant values we need to pass, wherein in case of copy constructor, the entire object as a parameter we need to pass. So this is the only difference between the parameterized and the copy constructor. So how we will come to know that the constructors are getting created, getting called, because we are not giving the explicit call to a particular constructor. So what we can do, we can write a simple print statement, object created, so that as an output we can come to know that the object is being created. So as you can see, the number is a default constructor. Here the simple object created cout statement I have written. So whenever the object is getting created, that the call will be given to this, and the respective message will be displayed. So same thing about the parameterized constructor, the two objects are getting created, and same thing for the copy constructor, the three objects are created. So the number of object created, those many number of times the particular constructor will get called based on the calling prototype, calling convention. So here n1, for n1 the default followed by parameterized followed by copy constructor will get created. So the next point is destructor. As we have seen, the constructors are used to allocate the memory for an object. The allocated memory must be destroyed whenever the object is not in use. So how the object will get destroyed? There is a special kind of function which is provided by C++, which is called as a destructor. So the destructor's prototype is, it also carries the same name as that of the class without any parameters. The only difference between the naming convention of constructor and destructor is, so at the time of writing the constructor, we need to give a tilde symbol, which indicates that this is the constructor. And just the opening and closing parenthesis, so the code or the destructor body is optional. So even if we write only the destructor name, opening and closing bracket, the object will get destroyed. Meaning what? The memory which has been associated with that object is getting destroyed. So the example, suppose three objects we have created, as we have seen in the previous example. We have done with the code, and whenever these objects are not in use or just before the return statement, the compiler does what? It gives the call to destructor and the objects will get destroyed. So as you can see, the object destroyed and object destroyed. Three times the object, this statement will be printed, because three objects we have created. So the memory which is associated with these three objects will be destroyed. So let me tell you how the objects are getting destroyed. See, whenever you call any function or whenever you create any object, so let's take an example. Let's say number is the class, and n1, n2 and n3, these three objects we have created. How the memory map of a particular program is created in the memory? It is by means of data structure, which is called as a stack. So whenever you give a program for the execution, the function's entry is made into a data structure which is called as a stack. So whenever I give any program for the execution, let's say main, so this you have written in main, let's say this is your main function, here you have written that, and this object is created, its entry is made into this one above the other. As this is a stack, stack is a last in first out kind of data structure. So whenever the objects are not in use, the entry will be deleted. So this n3 will be deleted, followed by this n2 will be deleted, followed by this n1 will be deleted. And once the return is executed, the main entry is also deleted, meaning your stack, which has been associated with a particular program, will be freed. And where this memory is given, the memory is given back to the operating system. So this is how the constructors and destructors are used to allocate and deallocate the memory. The constructors are getting called from left to right, the way you have created n1, n2 and n3. So this is the order of calling the constructors, and destructors are from right to left. Why? Because whenever the constructors are created, the constructors' entries are made into the stack, one above the other. And as this is last in first out kind of data structure, so whichever entry is made at the top of the stack, so this is called as top of the stack. So this will be popped out first, the memory is deallocated and it is given back to the operating system. Now once this is done, top will shift to this point. So n2 will be popped out and memory will be given to the operating system. The top will shift over here, n1 will be deleted and the memory will be given to the operating system. And once all the objects are destroyed, nothing is remained into the main. So main entry is also deleted and the entire memory or the entire block is deleted. This is how the particular entry of any C++ program is wiped out from the main memory, that is RAM, and the memory is free. So this is all about the constructors and destructors. Thank you.